Howdy creators! Today we want to show you why the 4:3 aspect ratio is good for your videos and how it helps achieve the best view possible. Let's start with a useful reminder. So, 360, 480, 720, 1080 and 4K. As you probably know, these are screen resolutions. 4:3, 3:2, 16:9, 1.85:1, 2.39:1. These are screen aspect ratios, or frame width to height ratios. Unlike photography and TV, where ratios are defined by even numbers, in cinematography they are defined differently. The short side equals to 1, while the longer side is measured by a decimal fraction based on the aspect ratio. Does that make sense? Let's get back to where we started. When you shoot a video on a camera, it's easy to miss an important detail that was slightly above or below your focus and simply did not fit into the frame. Here is an example. The first video has a 16:9 aspect ratio. The second one has an aspect ratio of 4:3. So when you shoot with the 16:9 aspect ratio camera settings, there is always a risk of losing a potentially valuable part of a video. Meanwhile, the 4:3 aspect ratio allows for capturing more details from the top and the bottom of a video frame. And that can make a big difference. The frame width remains the same as in the 16:9 ratio, but the height noticeably increases. This means that the best camera settings would be 1080 to 1440 resolution and the 4:3 aspect ratio. Here is an example. Let's compare the ways the frame space is used in real-life videos. The trick is to set the usual 1080 scene size when you start editing a video. Now, how to create a project using the best settings? When you import your video to the project, you'll notice that the size of your video will reduce to 75% from the original, because of the settings you've chosen. Don't get frustrated. Now, grab border of the video and drag it to the top. Repeat for the right side and stretch the video to fit the width of the scene. There you go! Now the video takes the 16:9 space, and you're free to move it a bit up or down to show the most valuable part of the footage while keeping the best quality. And by the way, you can repeat this trick for both horizontal and vertical axes. Now go ahead and try this for yourself. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. More useful videos are coming soon. Until next time!